Good day to you from ChemHelp ASAP. In this video, let's walk through two quick examples that highlight regioselectivity in the Diels-Alder cycloaddition. Our first reaction involves a diene called 2-methyl-1,3-butadiene, also known as isoprene, and a ketone called 1-butene-2-one, or methylvinyl ketone, or just MVK. The diene has an EDG, the methyl. Since the methyl is an EDG, let's imagine it has a minus charge. We can now give the diene charges. Next to the methyl would be a plus, and then alternate charges going away. The dienophile has an EWG, the ketone. That group is a plus, and so we can assign our charges to the dienophile carbons. I've already drawn these, the diene and dienophile, so that they line up with the opposite charges lined up. Side note, I'm also a fan of numbering atoms in the diene and dienophile. So here is the mechanism. It's a pretty big busy picture. And here is our expected product. Number everything. This is the 1,4 product because the EDG and EWG are four carbons away. It's also possible to form the 1,3 product, but this would be the minor regioisomer. Let's do another. The diene is 1-dimethylamino, 1,3-butadiene. The amine is an EDG, so it's a minus. Assign the imaginary charges on the diene accordingly. The dienophile now contains an alkyne. That's fine, as long as we have at least one C-C pi bond, and we do. The ester is an EWG. So it's plus, assign our charges. Again, I've drawn this so the diene and dienophile have aligned opposite charges. Let's number everything just to make everything a little bit busier in the picture. Here's the mechanism. And our expected product will have an extra pi bond in it because our starting material had an extra pi bond in it. So if we number our positions, the EDG and EWG are on adjacent carbons, so this is the 1,2 product, and this would be the expected major regioisomer. Great, those are two quick examples. I want to say two things before we finish. One, the charges we are drawing are not formal charges. These are imaginary charges that help us predict which ends of the diene connect with which ends of the dienophile. Two, this method of assigning imaginary charges is actually a shortcut that goes back to resonance. I would say that most instructors, and certainly most textbooks, emphasize drawing proper resonance forms with proper formal charges. The shortcut in this video works, but if your instructor wants you to draw resonance forms, then you need to know that method as well. All right, those are two sample problems in which we practice predicting the regiochemical outcome of the Diels-Alder cycloaddition.